Do you know why you're here?
Unpaid parking tickets, I think. Oh, no, no, wait. I killed an awful lot of people.
A sense of humor. I'm surprised.
See, I'm not all bad.
You're here because the state of Virginia mandates that all death row inmates complete a psychological evaluation in the days prior to their execution.
I have to be sane in order for the state to put me to death. How perverse.
Tell me, Joe, how are you feeling?
I'm feeling hopeful.
Heather, I'm Erin Reagan. I'm with the DA's office.
You got no right keeping me here like this. No right at all.
You're absolutely correct, and I apologize.
I have done nothing wrong. I haven't broken any laws. I should be free to go wherever and whenever I please.
It's true, and you are.
So I can leave?
Absolutely. I just wish you would listen to what I have to say.
I know what you have to say.
I'm a mother, too. Of an only child, a daughter just like you. So I know a little bit of what you must be feeling.
Then you should know better than to ask what you're asking.
You have a point. And if the tables were turned, I'd probably say exactly what you're thinking, which is get lost, take a hike.
I'm sorry. I really am. I do not want that police officer to die, but I cannot put my daughter in that situation. I'm sorry, I just can't.
It's not just Detective Bias's life at stake here. Typically, these things do not end well. There's a very good chance your husband is going to die today.
Miss Reagan, I am not a heartless person, but Anthony is not well. I have tried to save him more times than I care to count. And I just can't do it anymore.
Okay. But Penelope can. Will she ever forgive you if you deny her the chance to save her father's life?
How dare you? How dare you put that on me?
Sweetheart,
sweetheart.
I was just being honest.
What's going on?
Mom told Kate that she and Dad had sex before they were married. And not just that you had sex, but you enjoyed it. Ma, don't change the subject.
I am not.
You told Kate, she told a bunch of her friends, and now I'm the poster parent for sex.
Your old granddaughter asked me a direct question. What am I supposed to do?
Lie, like I did when she asked me.
Oh, come on.
Counselor called and left a message. Apparently, other parents are upset. I even called him back because I don't know what to say.
Get Monica called. Talk about what a stud dad was.
You're not helping. Jesse is adopted. What does that have to do with anything?
Did you ever come in contact with the biological parents?
No, he was a safe haven baby. Someone left him at a firehouse. Why?
We have reason to believe that Jesse's father might be Del Gruner.
What?
He's biological mother.
This is insane.
Insane would be a fair assessment. Mr. Gruner suffers from what must surely be clinical narcissism. That is why when he realized he'd impregnated his captive, he veered from what we believe to be his pattern.
That doesn't even make sense. Why would somebody do all that just to give him up?
Odds are he didn't know how to explain suddenly having a child.
His appointment at the Hearth and Home Foundation allowed him access.
I would like you to leave.
Please, we know how difficult this is to hear. We don't expect you to take it on faith. We just want to swab the inside of Jesse's cheek. If we're wrong and his DNA does not match Francine's, we'll know within a few hours.
Jim.
Hey, George. This is... I'm sorry, I forgot your name. We just met.
Miriam.
Nice to meet you. George Christopher. And this is Jonathan Ames.
Hello.
Ah, the man I want to meet.
It's very nice to meet you.
Would you excuse us? We have some business to talk.
Sure.
Thanks.
Okay. Are those hummingbirds?
Oh, yes, yeah. They're dipping their beaks into flowers.
I love them.
What was your name again?
Miriam. No, but his super told us you visit once a week.
Are you going to take your coat off? Did you just come from a job?
Okay, here's the deal. I don't break any laws. I don't allow any touching. My work isn't sexual. It's therapeutic.
You're a dominatrix. You help your clients work out their fantasies in a safe way. Have you ever met or heard Professor Lewis talk about this man, Jonas Tripp Slaughter?
Nope.
Were you working last Saturday night?
Yep, all night. My straight job. 911 operator.
911, that's a tough job. All the responsibility, none of the control. I guess in this life, you have the control. Because your clients, they... I guess they open up to you.
I'm not telling you what Larry's told me.
But it's his fault for bringing attention to you. He really needs to learn a lesson, I think.
Okay. Larry teaches business ethics, but he says it's all a sham. Says he sold out his ethics.
And that's why he needs to be punished?
Says he sold his wife to a billionaire for a book deal. I was weak. They bought me off. It's like a broken record. Just makes me want to smack him harder. I gotta take a shower. Could you let yourselves out?